Is Tesamorelin better than Ipamorelin? That question is kind of like asking me, do you like your son? Which son do you like better? And do you like them better than your daughter? Okay, so the short answer is yes and no. And in this video, what I'm going to do is deconstruct the difference between these two peptides, but also show you how they work synergistically and how one may be better for the other based on certain goals that you have. So by the end of this, you can say, okay, is Ipamorelin better for me or Tesamorelin? So let's jump in. So first of all, you've got to question why you're asking the question. And it goes back to clarity. You know, we have what's called the Ageless Future Operating System. So for each one of you, what I want to do is build a framework around your life so that you have this continual progression of improved health. And if I can transform your health by giving you the right information here on this video, or if I can get you to get blood labs ran, take some treatments that are going to benefit you, that's the goal, because I want you healthier every single year of your life. And one of the reasons why you probably are asking which one's better, Tesamorelin or Ipamorelin, is because they're two different peptides and you don't know which one is going to be best for you. But if your goal is you want to get the visceral fat down and you like to be only on things that are FDA approved, Tesamorelin is your way to go. Ipamorelin is not FDA approved for any medical conditions. It's been used for about 20 years and it's a very potent peptide. It works on a little different pathway, the ghrelin pathway, than most of the growth hormone releasing peptides do. There's about 100 different variants of growth hormone peptides. There's Massimorelin, there's Hexorelin, there's CJC1295, there's Tesamorelin, there's Ipamorelin, Sarcotropin. There's so many great peptides that just give your growth hormone a nudge without overriding your system and putting you at risk of disease. But the nice thing about Tesamorelin is it does have the clinical trials. And 12 years ago, it was FDA approved for treating lipodystrophy with HIV patients. And this peptide's proven to be very safe and very effective when it comes to building muscle and losing visceral fat. Now, Tesamorelin is a much larger amino acid structure. It's 44 amino acids. So what that means is it does fit on this category that raises a red flag for the FDA. Right now, they're trying to shrink the number of peptide sequences that are in a peptide structure, and then it gets triggered into a biologic over a certain level. Right now it's 40, but it is a moving target. Ipamorelin, why would you use Ipamorelin? Well, Ipamorelin seems to help subdue the hunger. So if you're somebody who struggles with a lot of hunger, I would be leaning into Ipamorelin, but you want the recovery, you want the muscle mass, you want the athleticism, you want the growth hormone impact to turn on BDNF in your brain so you can think clear. I would lean into Ipamorelin. Ipamorelin, as far as the clinical use goes, very well tolerated. It seems to activate more of the growth hormone response when you're using peptides like CJC1295 or Tesamorelin. If you don't want the hunger and you're already, you know, maybe you have issues where you've got a lot of food chatter, or maybe you're just getting off like a GLP-1 like Ozempic or Tirzepatide, you may want to consider just using Ipamorelin in the beginning, just to make sure that, you know, now that you've got less of that GLP-1 circulating in your body, you just don't want the hunger to come on and you just end up like destroying yourself metabolically. And that's Ipamorelin. Tesamorelin doesn't seem to pulse the hunger sensation as much as some of the other growth hormone peptides that I found. But I would use Tesamorelin if you're thinking of where you want the six pack, you have really big goals for the muscle density that you want to build. So maybe you want to put on 10 pounds in the next 2 months. Well, I would lean towards Tesamorelin. If you are somebody who just wants lean muscle, you just want better cardiovascular endurance, you want that benefit cognitively, I would go Ipamorelin. If you're somebody who struggles with type 2 diabetes, a lot of hunger, Ipamorelin again. Then again, on the flip side, here's the best way to use this. And this is what most people are not talking about, is where you stack Tesamorelin, Ipamorelin with BPC-157. Now, why? Well, the most impressive thing that we've seen is when you have BPC-157 active in your body, your receptors become a lot more sensitive, which is a good thing, to growth hormone. And when your body's more sensitive to growth hormone, that means you're going to recover quicker, you'll put on more muscle mass. And the other benefit of using BPC-157 with this is we want you eating more protein, but we want you to break it down. So BPC-157 helps stabilize the gastric secretions in your gut. The other powerful thing about BPC when used with growth hormone is some of the studies show that it creates more of this pleiotropic response where you have multiple pathways that start signaling. And then if you sprinkle in a little bit of a mitochondrial peptide, like maybe SLOOP-332, 5-amino-1-MQ, you're gonna notice just this athleticism that was dormant. You're gonna start feeling like a new human in like 30 days. The real benefit is not which one's better, tesamorelin, ipamorelin. The real benefit is when you bring these together. So maybe you've heard my symphony analysis, but what happens when you have like a cellist on stage, beautiful music, and then you bring a violinist up there, and then somebody's on like a saxophone. By the way, I'm not a musician, so if I get the wrong instrument, just go with me. Then you got the little snare drummer, and it's just like suddenly you've got this whole orchestra. Well, that's how you want to see peptides. You want to have very selective stacks of peptides that are precisely related to your lab. So I'm a big believer in predictive medicine. Most people are just using peptides because they saw a video like this, but they're not diving into the data and really analyzing the labs first. And then once you analyze it, then you want to put the peptide stacks in and you want to be cycling these every month. And then you want to retest and you want to say, okay, 6 months later, 3 months later, what are the improvements that actually happen? Because in any good science experiment, and I look at my whole body and I look at everything we do in medicine, it's called the practice of medicine, but we're applying the scientific method. We want to create a hypothesis. My hypothesis years ago, over a decade ago, was I believe when I stack peptides together, I improve faster than if I just do them one at a time. And what I noticed is not only did I have metrics to prove it, I had mountain biking times, I had my running times, I had VO2 max, I also had my data from my blood labs. I saw it in stool testing, metabolomics as well. And so I noticed as I started stacking those for my own health, a much bigger improvement. And then I started seeing it in my clients where we do ipamorelin with tesamorelin and BPC 157. And they would come back the next week and they're like, all right, Regan, what am I taking? This is amazing. Like I'm recovering faster, I'm sleeping better, I look better, and there's something different. And it was the stacking. So it's not thinking which one is better, which one's best. It's thinking, what are your goals and what do you want to accomplish? And then having the objective data matched with your goals, that's where you can really solve the problem. But once again, just in summary, if you don't want the hunger, and maybe you're not in a bulking phase, you just want to stay leaned out, I would start with ipamorelin. If you are really looking to bulk up fast and you want to lose any kind of visceral fat and you want something that's FDA approved, tesamorelin. The gold standard is when you can stack them together, ideally with BPC, thymus and beta 4, add in a mitochondrial peptide, and you'll thank me later. So if you love this video, make sure you grab a copy of my digital book, The Peptide Blueprint. We've got a free link for you below, and I hope you enjoy it. I'm Regan Archibald. Here's to your ageless future.